Hi everyone, my name is Ronald. I am an OFW based here in Singapore. I create travel requirements, travel guides, and other useful videos para sa ating mga OFW. We will talk about on how to get a job in Singapore or kung paano makakuha ng trabaho dito sa Singapore. So stay tuned, panoorin niyo yung buong video. I will give you some tips and useful job sites na pwede niyong puntahan. Have you considered working here in Singapore or have you tried venturing out in other countries? Pag-uusapan natin yan kung paano ba hina-hire dito yung mga foreigners at kung paano tayo makakahanap ng trabaho. So let's begin. Ano nga ba yung Ministry of Manpower? If you are in Philippines, ito yung counterpart ng DOLE, Department of Labor and Employment. Ministry of Manpower is a part of Singapore government. Sila yung nag-i-implement and facilitate ng mga rules or regulation para sa manpower or sa workforce dito sa Singapore. They are the one implementing the workforce quota. For example, merong isang foreigner, dapat ang quota niya is meron akong 6 or 7 locals or PR. So, yun yung quota ko. If I cannot have that, hindi ako pwede mag-hire ng foreigner. So, let's say, guys, meron na kayong nahanap na employer, okay na kayo lahat. Yung last approval will be from Ministry of Manpower or MOM. So, next topic is, ano ba yung mga common work pass or work visa for foreign worker like us? Okay. So, first one is yung EP or employment pass. Ito yung mga managerial job or executive job, mga matataas na job position. Next one is yung S-Pass. Ito yung mga mid-level skilled worker. Hindi na sa managerial job, mga junior staff. But depende pa rin sa company nyo kung ano yung bibigay sa inyo. So lastly is yung work permit. So ito yung mga domestic helper, construction, manufacturing job, shipyard, F&B, and so on. So madaming sector yan. If you wanna know what kind of work pass you are eligible, merong link under ng Ministry of Manpower for self-assessment tool. You can try if you work here in Singapore, if okay yung credentials nyo or yung information nyo for a job. So now you know what is Ministry of Manpower and you know what type of work pass that you will have in case you get to work here in Singapore. So the next topic naman, what are the requirements for you to get hired here in Singapore? So firstly is yung education. So I recommend that you should have a college degree or a bachelor's degree. Yung pinag-aralan nyo is relevant dun sa trabaho na hahanapin nyo. Like for nursing, dapat sa medical field or sa medical industry din yung pinag-aralan nyo. Same goes with the experience, the another requirement. So you should have at least 2 to 3 years work experience sa Pilipinas or other country for you to get hired here in Singapore. But I'm not an expert, guys. This is just based purely on my experience, okay? So that's the requirements, relevant experience and education. And also your resume. Next topic is the job sites. I'll give you the first 5 job portals that I recommend and I use. So first one is, of course, yung JobStreet and JobsDB. Even if you are in Philippines, I'm sure ginagamit nyo rin tong dalawang website na to. Next one is LinkedIn. Basta active ka lang and you have a lot of connections. Ayusin nyo lang yung profile nyo sa LinkedIn, yung photo, update your information there. Next one is Glassdoor. I'm also using this. So just key in your job description or the keyword na hinahanap nyo. And finally is Indeed. I-N-D-E-E-D. Indeed website. Ito yung pinakahuli kong ginagamit. Yan. So these 5 websites, you can try and create an account. You can use 1 email for all of these job sites and same password para di na kayo mahirapan. I still have more job portals that I want to share with you, but just be extra careful. I haven't tried them. So you have recruit.net, GrabJobs, Glint, Job Central, E27, and FastJobs. If you have spare time, you can visit these other links that I've mentioned. I am not an expert in building resume. I don't have a background in human resource. So, gusto ko na i-share sa inyo yung experience ko. So, if you are doing your resume, make it clean. Huwag masyadong mataas yung file size. Hindi naman kailangan fancy unless you are a graphic design. Best also if you can make it 2 pages. Kasi hindi naman lahat ng employer, they have the time to scroll down and search for, you know, WhatsApp is the common messenger here in Singapore. So if an employer wants to communicate with you or get in touch with you, kung meron kayong WhatsApp, directly. Ingat lang tayo guys sa mga phishing or fake employers or fake companies. Make sure na i-double check niyo yung number and ask few questions kung paano nahanap yung contact number niyo. If you have a friend or a family here in Singapore, I suggest you can put that address instead of your address in Philippines so that your employer won't hesitate to ask you for an interview like, oh, nasa Singapore pala to. Sometimes they can also do a Zoom meeting or Zoom interview. So it really depends on the company. Mali. Oh, this is my bonus link that I can share with you guys. This is in Marina Bay Sands. Ito yung hotel na kilala dito sa Singapore. I have a link. You can apply for a job. Another one is Shopee. Alam nyo may Shopee, malaki yun, di ba? So, you can try out and send your resume. And lastly is yung Resorts World Sentosa. Ayan. So, ito yung tatlong big companies dito sa Singapore. So, check out the link below. Send yun yung resume nyo. Ayan. So, good luck, guys. And if you like this kind of video, just let me know. Again, if you haven't subscribed, please do. And I will see you again on my next video.